in physical geography, we studied lithosphere, atmosphere, hydrosphere, and biosphere. Then, sometimes some ask what is need of environmental geography, because the combination of these four spheres, that is lithosphere, atmosphere, hydrosphere, and biosphere, is environment. Environment is the surrounding that may be biotic and abiotic. Thus, there should not be individual existence of environmental geography. But it is not so. Environment is all pervading subject. And in ancient Gurukul system of education, the pupils got admission in Gurukul and he lived with Guru in open sky environment. At that time, the perception of environment in the pupils was very much clear, because they had to live and survive in and with environment. But today, the classroom education has deprived the students of the environmental perceptions. That's why the environmental studies have been introduced in different classes, ranging from primary section as EVS to BSc, MSc and PG levels. In higher classes, some universities have introduced the compulsory education of environment, environmental hazard, environmental management, and in BSc, MSc, ecological sciences. Thus, it is a very important knowledge today, which should be imparted to all living on the earth. Due to the confinement of the environmental studies in classrooms today, the sentiments of people, especially economic and scientific people, is not so much with the environment. That's why there is large-scale environmental degradation, resulting into sometimes natural hazards. That's why the perception, knowledge, and legislation for the understanding of environment has become today must. This course is for UG and PG students of geography, and especially MSc students, and for all. Because in competitions, a number of questions are being asked related to environment, and the environmental challenges are increasing day by day. To understand the syllabus of environmental geography, we have to differentiate the meaning of three terms, which have been frequently used in the syllabus of environmental geography. First term is environment, second is ecology, third is ecosystem. What is environment? Suppose you are standing here, then for you, there are a number of environments are surrounding. For example, number one is atmospheric environment, which directly affects us. Number two, lithospheric environment, which directly or indirectly affects us. And number three, hydrospheric environment. Number four, pedospheric environment. And number five, biospheric environment. These are the environment and have number of components affecting you. Thus, it is your environment. Suppose here is one plant. What is the plant's environment? All the same things. This plant is affected by the atmospheric, lithospheric, hydrospheric, pedospheric, and biospheric means animals and man. Thus, the environment is the combination of the gradients of the surrounding abiotic and biotic factors. This environment differs from the atmosphere. How? Because if somebody asks what is the environment of study for a student in Allahabad, he may ask what is the atmosphere of study. So there is a minute difference between atmosphere and environment, because atmosphere is a part of environment. So the question should be that the environment of study in Allahabad is good, not atmosphere of the Allahabad for study is good. Next is ecology. If you have understood that the environment is the combination of all the biotic and abiotic factors surrounding us, then it is easy to understand ecology. Ecology is the study of all types of relations. Those relations may be friendly and those relations may be enmically. So all types of relation among all the factors of all the biotic and abiotic components. For example, there is a relation between sunlight and heat and this grass. Both are interrelated mutually. Likewise, this lithospheric ingredient, maybe calcium, potassium, magnesium, has relation with the biotic grass, shrubs or forest plant. Thus, when we study these relations, it is called ecology and it is ecological science. In the same way, this is pedosphere, this is hydrosphere, and this plant is component of biosphere. This biosphere means plant is related with this pedosphere, mutually relationship there is. Likewise, this plant is related with this hydrosphere, because hydrosphere means water affects this plant and plant in turn affects this amount of water. How? This plant makes evaporation which precipitates in the form of rain, and this again comes here, which is water cycle. Thus, after understanding environment, we have known what is ecology. Ecology means interrelationship. But third term is ecosystem. If there is interrelation, then certainly there should be some process through which energy or matter moves, flows. So in ecosystem, we study the process and the rate of flow of energy and biogeochemical cycle. It means, suppose the insolation means light and heat is coming from the sun, and these are being received by the grasses, shrubs and plant leaves for photosynthesis, then this abiotic energy of light and heat is being converted into biotic energy, glucose, by the plants. That energy moves in goat and in lion, then lion roars, and that sound energy is again released to the atmosphere. This way, abiotic energy becomes biotic in plant, goat and lion, and then it in the form of sound becomes abiotic and back to space. Thus, this is energy flow connecting all the abiotic and biotic components of our atmosphere. This study of the unidirectional energy flow is the subject matter of ecosystem, not ecology, not environment. It means ecosystem is the deep knowledge of process. The second part of ecosystem study is the geochemicals like calcium, potassium, magnesium, etc., which are found in soil or rock are abiotic. But when plant roots take that calcium, it in those plants become biotic, and that biotic calcium is taken by the goat, then lion through food chain or food web, and at the death of lion, that calcium again meets the soil, comes back to the soil. Thus a cycle is being completed. It is not energy flow, rather it is biogeochemical cycle. Thus the ecosystem is the study of the processes and their rate in the abiotic and biotic components. It might have been very much clear to you what is difference between environment. In environment, we study all the abiotic and biotic component individually, while in ecology, we study that all the biotic and abiotic components are interrelated, while in third, ecosystem, that is the supreme level of the study, is the ecosystem, wherein we study that the energy flow and biogeochemical cycles interrelate these. Thus, these three terms have been used in your entire syllabus. Now, our syllabus starts from topic 1 to here. This is the physical part of the knowledge of environment or ecosystem or ecology. Then from here, the human interference starts in the ecology or ecosystem or environment. And at last, policies, management and education have been emphasized, which are the basic need of the present hour. Because previously there were three basic needs. Number one, food, clothes and shelter. Today, the fourth basic need has become healthy, fresh environment. Now, the first topic is principles of ecology. Principles show that there are some facts, natural truth, on the basis of which the environment existed in past, existing at present, and it will continue. The second topic is interrelation of energy flow. As we have discussed that from the sun, energy, light and heat comes, and for photosynthesis being absorbed by the plant, grass, and then it moves through food chain and again in the sound form retreats back to space. The next topic is water circulation. Water is the main agent for circulating food chain, for circulating the solar energy and biogeochemical cycle. For example, here it is water which is being absorbed by the plant root, and that through stem, branches and leaf reaches here, which is being evaporated. After evaporation, it is condensed and causes precipitation or rainfall. Thus, water cycle is completed. This water circulation differs from hydrological cycle. That will be discussed in detail in this topic. Next is biogeochemical cycle, in which we study the motion of chemical from the abiotic lithosphere to this grass, then goat, then lion, and ultimately it gets back and reaches the lithosphere. This is cyclic, not in flow like energy. Next topic is concept of ecosystem. that we have studied in detail, wherein we shall study the different types of pyramid and food chain, food web therein. Next is geomorphic process and ecosystem. In geomorphology, we have already studied geomorphic processes, which are of two types, endogenic and exogenic, and these are interrelated with ecosystem also. For example, there was Tethys geosyncline in geological past, and the ecosystem there was aquatic. But after the endogenic forces made pressure, and Himalayas came into existence there. Now on Himalayas, ecosystem is not aquatic, rather it is terrestrial and it is mountain ecosystem. Likewise, other exogenic processes like river erosion or marine erosion, those also change the ecosystem in specific areas. Next is biotic community and soil. On world map, if you draw the map of soil, you will get that the soil zones vary from equator to taiga. Likewise, the biotic communities also vary latitudinally. For example, in equatorial region, there is laterite soil belt, and in equatorial region, there is the equatorial biotic community that consists of equatorial evergreen forest and animals. Thus, these are complementary to each other. There may be one question that whether here topic should have been written as biotic communities and soil, or soil and biotic community. Be clear here, because it is soil that affects biotic community. Because as per the change of soil zones, biotic community means plants and animals change. But here our main focus of study will be that how biotic communities from equator to pole change or affect the soil. Thus, these are the some very important topics which pertain to the physical aspect of environment, ecology and ecosystem. But it is man, economic, technological and greedy man who is looking towards the environmental resources with greed, and that's why there are studied some topics to be studied emphasizing on the mind. Here one topic is human ecological adaptation. In from equator to pole, people are distributed, and there are different environmental or ecological conditions where people survive, and for their survival they have to adapt with the environmental conditions. For example, pygmies with equatorial environment, Eskimo with tundra environment. Likewise, there is a one point, adjustment. In adjustment, people bring about minor or major change in their environment. For example, people in hot desert region use the AC and other scientific instruments. Next topic is influence of man on ecology and environment. Actually, when man will adapt with the environment, there will be no ecological imbalance and environmental degradation. But as man will start adjustment with environment, the environmental pollution and ecological imbalance will start. That's why this chapter will focus on the influence of man or human activities on the ecology and environment. Certainly, today, human activities, interactions with environmental resources are increasing day by day. That's why this chapter has become of paramount significance. Next point is global and regional ecological imbalance. Due to human interference at regional and global level, there is an ecological imbalance. Ecological imbalance means the interrelation between the abiotic and biotic components is being deranged or damaged. That's why next point will be ecosystem, their management and conservation. If ecology or relationship will be disturbed, certainly the ecosystem will also be disturbed. For example, the energy flow and biogeochemical cycles will be disturbed. That's why the need of ecosystem management and its conservation arises. Next point will be environmental degradation management and conservation. These two topics seem to be repeated, but there is no repetition. Virtually, ecosystem management and conservation differs from environmental management and conservation, because when the process of ecosystem will be disturbed, certainly the components of biotic and abiotic environment will undergo degradation, for which separate management and conservation needed. Next point is biodiversity and sustainable development. Today, at global level, there is a biodiversity from equatorial evergreen forest to the taiga climate, and that's why there is different biodiversity regions, but these biodiversities are being depleted due to environmental degradation. For that, there are different laws, concepts which may preserve and conserve biodiversity, and on the basis of that, the development may be made sustainable. Next point is environmental hazards and remedial measures. There are two types of environmental hazards. One is natural and second is man-induced. Today, a type of natural hazards like micro-earthquakes, like small-scale cyclones, are caused by human developmental activities. That's why these are also subject matter of environment or environmental geography. And these hazards are fatal for the human society. That's why to control those hazards, some steps have been prepared and the remedial measures have been proposed. Next topic is environmental policy. To control these hazards and keep the environment safe and make sustainable development, some environmental policies which have been framed at national level by national governments and at international level by United Nations Environment Development Program. If there are very good policies formulated by some agency, but its knowledge is not being imparted to the common man, then it is very difficult to control the pollutions. That's why the last but not least topic is environmental education and legislation. For this, all the governments have started imparting environmental education, starting from nursery classes. Like the course in nursery or pre-primary classes is EVS, Environmental Sciences, and in higher classes, some universities have made compulsory to pass the course of environment or environmental hazard. Such types of courses have been prescribed, and these educations at different levels are being imparted, and some legislations also have been made by the state and central governments or local governments to keep the environment free from human actions, human activities, and make sustainable development. Thus, these are the topics related to the environmental geography, and this helps in the study of environmental sciences.